guys, welcome to the Glam Studio. This is Arzu here, your makeup expert from MyGlam. And today's live is all about lipstick cocktail. And my beautiful model is right here. Her name is Naz. Hi Naz. So basically lipstick cocktail, the topic is like I'm going to mix a couple of lipsticks together, create new different shades, also add some new products like highlighters and you know mix foundations on your lipstick so that you can create your own different looks. So yes, I'll start with one. Right now I'm gonna be using Perfect Curves lipstick. I'm gonna be using two shades. One is gonna be Carnation and one is gonna be Soleil. First I'll show you the shades. So this is Soleil. It's a bright orange. And this is Carnation. It's a bright pink. So basically the mixing of these two colors is that when you have too many bright colors and you don't know that you know which one you should be wearing, and also it's always a great idea to mix two shades so you can you know create your own shade and get the right shade for your face. So right now first I'll be using is Carnation. I'm mixing these two shades to tone down the brightness, and also then I'll add a little bit of highlighter to create a bolder look. She has an amazing lip shape. So the right way of applying a lipstick is always first to create a cupid's bow and then go on the edges from the cupid's bow till the end. Quick tip, always if you want to make your lipstick more long lasting, first you can powder and foundation your lips or maybe add some concealer so that your lipstick is more long lasting. I'll be using more of Carnation because I want the shade to be a little bit on the pinkish side more. So as you can see, I'm putting the lipstick all over her lip, but the intensity is quite less, like just one tone of it. The look after applying Carnation. And now I'm taking Soleil, which is a bright orange. I'm just gonna add on the Carnation that I've applied. So if you can see, that is turning out to be a little bit on the peachish side. You can see the difference in the lower lip and the upper lip. The upper lip is just with Carnation and the lower lip is with Carnation and Soleil. So this is the look if when you mix two shades. I have mixed Soleil and Carnation and this is the outcome. Now if you want to change this look, if you want to keep it matte, you can always keep it matte. But if you want to make it glossy, what you can do is you can maybe add some gloss to it. So I'm just taking Beauty Shot Color Fusion lipstick and I'm going to be using the plumping gloss to give it a plumping effect as well as to make it a little bit more lively. So I'm just going to apply the gloss on the center of her lip. Right now, before it was a complete matte texture. Now after adding the gloss, it has turned out to be a little bit semi-matte texture. And on top of the skin, just blend a little bit. So you can see the outcome after adding the gloss. And after this, I'm going to show you a quick tip if you want to go out for a runway or you know if you're going out for a nice clubbing scene or a party scene. What you can do is just take some highlighter. Right now, what I'll be using is the highlighter from the Chisel It palette. And it's called Showstopper, so I'm using the highlighter. Just taking some on my brush. And I'm just gonna dab some on the center of her lip. So if you see, after adding the little bit of highlighter on her lips, it looks even more bigger and even more poppier. Can you just blend a little bit? So you can see, this is what I've done. So I'll again like break down what I've done. I mixed two lipsticks. One was Soleil and one was Carnation, and after that I added a gloss from the Color Fusion lipstick. This one, it's a nude gloss, and to change the look even more further, I added a little bit of highlighter from the Chisel It palette, and this is what it's up. So you can always create different looks. This was a more glamorous kind of a look. Now I'm just gonna give Naz a wet wipe so that she can remove this thing. So now I'm gonna, this was like all bright shades. Now I'm gonna show you how to create a darker shade. You know, sometimes I'm just too bored of, you know, a lot of people are too bored of wearing reds and browns and you know all of that. So So sometimes when you only have two options, that is a red and a brown, what you can do is you can mix the two shades and create a very nice dark maroonish type of a shade by yourself. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to first clean the brush, which is very important. Always be hygienic. I'm just cleaning the brush so that all the lipstick which was left on the brush comes off. And now I'm using a shade called Terra, which is my most favorite shade from this collection. And the second shade which I'll be using is called Siren. It's a red. So then I'll be mixing these two shades. And after mixing these two shades, I'll show you how to instantly tone down the color by using a foundation. Okay, so first I am using the brown shade, which is Terra. And I'll be going all over her lip. Again, the same trick. Always start with the Cupid's bow so that you can never go wrong with the shade. And yeah, girls, please hydrate your lips. Before putting all of this, it is very important to use a lip balm so that the original condition of your lips does not get harmed in any way. Because all these lipsticks have a lot of color, a lot of pigmentation, so you need to protect your lips. Terra is a color which you can wear like all the time, even when you're working. It's a proper nice brown brick shade, which goes on with almost everything. With the office look, sometimes when you're wearing like nice, you know, you go out for lunch or something, at that time also you can wear a nice brown shade. But I always, encourage mixing lipsticks because it gives you your own shade and something which nobody has because it's your own creation. So I've used Terra on her right now and you guys can see how Terra looks. And now I'm just taking the shade called Siren. It's a red shade. And I'm going to be mixing it with the Terra. So basically it will give you a nice brickish red undertone, you know, like it won't even be red, won't even be brown, but something between the two which looks nice. And trust me, I've tried all these mixtures being a makeup artist and they work wonders. People actually keep on asking you which shade is this, which shade is this, and trust me, you have no answer because it's your own creation and there's no name to it. Unless and until you yourself create a name and give it. So this is how your lipstick will look when you mix the two shades called Terra and Siren from the Perfect Curves collection from MyGlam. And this is the look, the outcome which you get. And now I'm just going to be adding a little bit of, you know, foundation to show you how you can instantly tone down any color. So for example, you know, you might end up buying a lipstick which is too dark for your face or something like that. Then you can tone down the color by adding a little bit of foundation on your lips, just a little bit, not too much, to tone down the color. And also at the same time, the best part about this is it will make your lipstick more long lasting. So I'm just adding a little bit of foundation, as you can see. See the difference in the lower lip and the upper lip once you add the foundation. So you can see the same shade which was too dark just a couple of seconds ago. After adding a little bit of foundation on it, the color has toned out. It has turned out to be a little bit of lighter tone. And yeah, the best thing is if you want to make this glamorous, we have a nice product called Powder Magic. It's a powder eyeshadow stick and eyeliner. So I'm just going to show you how quickly you can use this on your lips to create any kind of different art. So I'm just using a shade which will match to my lipstick, and that will be Amethyst. Yes. I'm just adding a little bit on the center of her lips to give it a nice professional touch. So after this, I'm just gonna make sure that everything is blended properly. Like you can see, the sides are matte, the center of the lips is a little bit glossy, not too much, just a little bit of shine. And again, yeah, you can add a lot of gloss to it if you want instead of the powder, and then make it more glamorous. And now, yes, I'll just add a little bit of more shine, the powder highlighter. That's another kind of lip art with using different lipsticks. So again, I'll break down the look. It is the shade called Terra and Siren. And after that I added a little bit of foundation just to tone down the color. And after that I added the Powder Magic eyeshadow on the center of her lips. And then after that I added a little bit of highlighter from the palette Showstopper again to give that highlighted look. So yeah, that's it. And yeah, the best trick is if you want to make the color more intensified, more darker, what you can do is take any black color or anything, you know. I'm going to be using the Stay Define, a brown color. I'm going to be using the High Definition Eyebrow Fill-In Powder on the corners to give it a more defined look. This is a trick which you can use when you want to make any shade darker. We use the foundation to make the shade lighter, but if you want to make any shade darker, you have to take a darker color. Right now I use the Stay Define Eyebrow Filling Powder, which is a brown shade. And since the lipstick was also brown in shade called Terra, so I've used the brown to make the corners more defined and more intense. So if you can see, the corners of her lips are more defined and more darker, and the center is more plumped out. Alright guys, thank you so much. I hope I have given you a few good tips for creating nice lip art, basically lip cocktail. Thank you. This is Arzu signing off from Glam Studio. See you tomorrow. Bye.